We're broadcasting from B&B Spank Stadium in Brawltimore, Scaryland. There's some history behind this team, Bricks. 23 years ago, the original Cleveland Burns snuck out of Cleveland, leaving their fans heartbroken. They relocated to Brawltimore and renamed themselves the Razors.
Well, if they were based in Cleveland, Grim, I can completely understand the move.
Yeah, this is going to be a bloody game. The teams are loading their weapons and sharpening their spikes. The Orcs of Hazzard battle the Brawltimore Razors. Welcome to MFL Game Day. Grim Blitzrow here. Let's listen in on the sidelines and hear what the team's captains have to say. If you like your cocktail cold, your soup hot, and your steak still mooing, then you're gonna love seeing mutants knocked cold, their brains turned into hot lava soup, and their bodies strewn about the field, lying still and barely moving. MFL Game Day is on the air.
Aw, you just made me hungry, Grim. I'm gonna go get some of them extra crispy mutant finger strips.
Hey, get me a full slab of broken mutant ribs while you're there.
It's not how many times you fall, it's how you get back up.
Yeah, in this particular case, I'm thinking defibrillators and 100 cc's of adrenaline.
Yeah, they both wouldn't hurt either.
Did somebody say cocaine?
And it's first and 10. And he just used his beast boost dirty trick, and there's no way to stop him. Unless, of course, you kill him.
Wow, look at that freak go! He's unstoppable!
Boom to the moon! Another loser bites the dust. In the MFL, winning is really about how much you want it, Bricks.
Well, he clearly didn't want to live as much as the other guy. That's a good point, Grim.
Six.
Ouch! What is this, 80s wrestling?
Second down and 2. And he punched his way out of that tackle. Boom! The ref calls a penalty. You know, the MFL has eliminated almost every penalty in the rule book, and yet it still feels like there's way too many penalties.
Stupid jerks. You guys suck.
And that'll bring up 3rd and 1. Should be easy, but with kickers, you never know. It's good. When you give up points, you need to get them back. Here comes the kickoff. Let's see if they can make them pay. First and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Oh, that hit's gonna shave a few days off his life. Oh, holy Montezuma's revenge. That's a crap your pants and die tackle. Oh, that Montezuma was very vengeful, wasn't he, Bricks? Wonder what made him so mad.
Yeah, it was probably all the diarrhea.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Yeah, they probably ran out of toilet paper when he was in some all-inclusive resort, and he just got so mad and cursed everyone who came to Mexico forever to crap their pants. Sounds like he didn't really think it through, because, you know, he should have made it.
Oh, and that's what they call the money shot. And the defense scrubbed it out and came up with the ball. Oh, nice hit. First and 10. And the defense just called the ginormous dirty trick. Oh, that's a vicious hit. And the crowd loves it.
He just turned that guy into 300 pounds of ground mutant meat.
And you can't hit a guy much harder than that. And that is unfortunate. And he was stuck to him like glue. Second down and 10. He's not going down. Oh, and he breaks free and has nothing but open field in front of him. You know, in the pre-apocalypse, they would flag this kind of thing. Is running low on quarterbacks. They have only two left. He might consider running the ball more. And they line up for the extra point. It goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
The home crowd isn't impressed with that showing. But their team has a chance to respond. Bam! Say goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
Goodnight to that guy, Bricks.
You're an idiot.
The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim?
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two, hot nine.
A great run for a 9-yard gain. Boom, dead and down. Nothing more to say about this guy except maybe a eulogy.
Well, he was a violent alcoholic, a terrible father, and he did some nasty things to dogs. But, he was a great ball player. That's really what counts at the end of the day, right?
Hot one, hot two, hot.
First down! And this guy is a stud, Bricks.
And whoever said never hit a man when he's down is just plain lazy. Nice extra effort there.
And it's first and 10. Second down and 9. And the defense was reading him like a book.
Like it was written in Braille, Grim. His hands were all over.
Oh, what a great defensive play that was, Bricks. Kind of like your Aunt Bertha. This guy has some big balls. What a hit.
Yeah, she does have a big pair, Grim. You're right.
You are digging some butternut time.
And it's first and 10. He refuses to go down, and he's off to the races. Look at that little mutant run.
I don't think you can say that, Grim.
Well, I'm going to say it, and then I'm going to
And here comes the extra point attempt. The kick is good.
As expected.
Oh, holy smokes. He just killed that player with a cheap shot. That's why we love the MFL. When you get knocked down, you got to get right back up and fight.
What about when you get knocked up? What do you do then?
Run.
Don't you just love the sound of bones snapping and cracking?
Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. The burn returner was killed on that play. The coach will replace him with another player. And it's first and ten. No doubt about it, that guy is dead. He says, I'm taking you with me. First and ten.
Hey man, nobody can touch you with an eyeball. I take all you mutants out. That's right. Hey, what you talking about?
Second down and a lot.
That QB, I'd be pissed.
Third down, and the offense needs a miracle. Wrestles away from that tackle. And he's able to grab that one somehow and hold on for the first down.
This guy has a nice set of hands, Grim. It's the third set of hands he's had sewn on today. Looks like it's a good fit.
Boom! First and ten. And he'll pick up 7 yards on that play. Second and three. And he put on the afterburners after that catch and scored. Nicely done!
Just one. Just had some fun on your time.
Okay, nice and easy like a 2-foot putt.
You miss 2-foot putts all the time, Grim!
Goes right through.
Yeah, like a double stuffed burrito from Taco Hell.
They're looking for a good return after giving up points. Let's see how they do.
Yeah, let's see if they always suck or if that was just a one-time thing.
And that's a hell of a cheap shot. Gotta love it. The burn returner was maimed by the opposing team, so it's up to the next man to replace him.
Yeah, what exactly is a burn returner, Grim.
Now, players who catch kickoffs and punts and run them back through the teeth of the defense. They have the lowest survivability rate of any player in the league.
The next man up just sat back down on the bench. He probably cramped his pants.
And it's first and 10. He took a beef boost injection. Now watch him stomp all over his opponents.
I want to take a beef boost injection, too.
Now, that has weird side effects, Bricks. His cleats are caked in blood and guts, and he's looking to score. He's at the 30. Boom, dead and down. He just sent a message with that hit.
Yeah, the message was you can't kill the messenger, because he's going to kill you. But then he won't be able to read the message, because the messenger killed him. I'm going in circles.
Boom, dead and down.
You delivered the freaky fast ham a sandwich with extra mustard for the...
Oh, mama. Just call him Cap'n Crunch. Another one bites the dust. The offense has no running backs left, so this becomes a passing-only offense.
They can still run it with their QB, right, Ben?
Sure, they can run their QB into the defense that's feasting on runners. Sounds like a good plan, moron.
Hey, watch it!
It's the end of the first quarter, and I just want to say that this is the ugliest thing I've ever seen. Other than my mother-in-law, of course. And it's first and 10.
Hot one, hot two.
Second down and long. And he breaks away. And he finds open spaces running toward the end zone.
Turn on your jets, you son of a bitch.
Second down, and we've got a pick. And the offense jumps off sides to kill the ref. They say, we're mad as hell and not going to take it anymore. Second down in a mile. And that's a run for no gain.
Then it's not really a run, is it?
Third down, and the QB is saying his prayers.
Hot one, hot two.
Many things better than a running
back. Oh, man, he just killed that guy when the play was over.
Well, if the ref didn't see it, at least the mortician did. He's coming out in the field now. Don't do anything stupid here. Just punt the damn ball and play defense. And he got it off. That's a decent punt. Nice catch, and he turns on the afterburner. Oh, with the brutal hit. It's first and 10. And he sticks his fingers in the defender's eyes, hitting him a pickup of about... Oh, that was totally uncalled for. And that's why we love the MFL. Second down and a lot. And like bricks and... Oh, man, his neck vertebrae just got crunched. Sounded like a gorilla sitting on a bag of potatoes. He's leaving it all out on the field today. And there's his large intestines over there in his liver.
I think his spleen is stuck on that guy's cleat.
No, that's a gallbladder.
Ah, my bad.
charging it.
Imbecile!
And it's first and ten. He runs it for three. Second down and seven. And another interception. This quarterback is going to listen to Joy Division, and he sends him to the ground with an exclamation point.
And a well-placed cleat.
First and ten. And there's another pick. Man, this quarter. And the MFL keeps pounding out the death hits on WMFL 90. Oh, and the late hit arrives right on time. When it's your time to go, it's your time. Razors lose the game by forfeit. And as you know, Bricks, forfeit is the ancient Latin word for an ass-kicking. It's probably a good thing the game ended up in forfeit. They weren't going to make it out of the stadium alive with this performance anyway. The fans were going to kill them if the opposition didn't.
Gotta love that fan passion.
Let's hear what the game's MVP has to say about this carnage.
I'd rather listen to Sarah Palin read the entire works of Shakespeare while tripping my brains out.
Actually, that sounds kind of fun.
Today's final game stands are brought to you by the Micro Hard Corporation. They get it right every up.